What's up, everybody? My name is Leihua, and welcome to the Superfina channel. I am a Hawaii variety content creator, host of podcasts across worlds, and I stream on twitch.tv/LeihuaSuperfina. Today, we are reviewing Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nakatoto, and if you like anime reviews, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell so you can be notified on the next upload. And if you would like to support the channel, we got Patreon and channel memberships. Link to those are below. We are reviewing Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nakatoto, but instead of doing like an episode review like I usually do, we are going to review on a character, and that is Nakatoto. I find Nakatoto pretty fascinating, especially the transition or the changes of her throughout the season. When we first see her, we see that she is a tan girl, which is very similar to like a gyaru, a gal, and they sort of have like a stereotypical on them. They are a stereotype. And when we see her, she's teasing senpai, so it looks like she's bullying him, so it looks like she's fitting in that stereotype where gyarus are mean and they just pick on people and such. You're kind of like uncouth, I want to say, like that's the stereotype. As we see her more and we see her interacting with senpai, we can see that she actually likes him. Now the thing is, when does it change from I'm interested in you, I want to be friends with you, and romantic? Like, when are those changes happening? Because in the beginning, it seems like she's just interested in him. Like, senpai piqued her interest. And if you notice, she doesn't introduce herself outright. She just says, oh, you're my senpai, I'm your kohai. And then later on, as I guess she gets to know him more, she talks to him more, she introduces herself. She tells him her name. Now over there, I'm thinking, okay, this is where she wants to establish her relationship with him. Like, she wants to be friends with this guy. She's telling him her name. Then later on, we just see her visiting his art room, the art club, interacting with him more, and it's like she just has fun teasing him. Like, she just has a really good time hanging out with him. She loves seeing his reactions. She feels comfortable. Like, she feels comfortable that she can say anything to him. And he gets mad at her, but he doesn't get mad. Like, she's never been malicious. And there's only been one time in the season where his feelings were hurt, and he's like, hey, stop it. And I believe that was when she was talking about his hair and such. And she didn't mean to. She didn't mean to hurt his feelings, and she felt so bad. So this is where you know she was never malicious in this whole thing. She was just having good fun, teasing him. And there are some times where she like calls him out. And when I say call him out, I mean a lot of the stuff is kind of like borderline sexual. Like, there's sexual harassment and calling him out on sexual stuff, like asking him or calling him out if he has the balls to even do anything. And this is where it's like, okay, were you serious when you wanted to do some stuff with him, or were you like just poking fun at him? That's where it's like, where did it change? Or was she always interested in the beginning? Or was she joking and then she became interested? It's like, huh. You would need to like analyze this, like really analyze these episodes to like see where it happened. But it's like earlier on in the episodes, there was some physical contact, you know? Like the episode where they're talking about vampires and such, and then she falls on him and like she touches his, you know, that area down there, and she's like shocked, and it's like, oh, did she do that on purpose? But no, she's like really like surprised and she's embarrassed by it. So in this area, this is where we know that she comes off like she's really experienced, like no biggie, I can talk about this stuff, I can talk about sex and whatnot. But when she's actually in the act or anything related to it, she is embarrassed, she is shy. So it's like, girl, you're actually innocent. So Nakato is actually very innocent. She just likes to talk about this stuff, provoke Senpai, and not provoke in a bad way, but just provoke emotions, reactions out of him. And then throughout the season, we just see her be a little bit more aggressive, a little bit more straightforward on her intentions with him. Like, for example, when he first did a drawing of her and she brought the couch, she laid in the couch, she was sleeping, and he's like, oh, aren't you worried that I'll do something? And she's like, no, because I know you won't really do anything, but you can. And it cuts off. It cuts off with her saying like that he can. So that's where we know, okay, she does want him to reciprocate on her feelings. She does want him to do something. And what I like about this show is you know that they like each other. You know Nagato, especially Nagato, that she likes him. And she's putting herself out there. She is pretty much dropping big hints that she likes him. And also acting like she wants to be with him. She's acting like they are together. She's acting like he is her possession. He is hers. And we definitely see that when we interact with her friends. So you know that episode when Nagato introduces Senpai to her friends, Gamo and Yoshi? Nagato introduces Senpai as her boyfriend. Like, Yoshi asks, is this your boyfriend? And Yakatoto is like, yes, this is my boyfriend. And it's like, do you consider him as your boyfriend? And this is where it's like, Nagato does this thing where when something happens where it's like, it's progressing, the relationship is progressing, and it's like there's an awkward silence thing going on, like there's awkwardness, and what she does is she plays it off. She makes fun of it, lightens it up, so it's not awkward between Senpai and Nagato anymore. So in this scene, where Yoshi asks, oh, is this your boyfriend? Nagato is like, yes, this is my boyfriend. Where it's like, okay, we know you want him to be your boyfriend, but you're making light of it. So this is another example of how Nagato is putting herself forward. She's letting Senpai know, I like you, I want to be with you. But for his sake, she lightens it. She doesn't make it so serious. But it's all this stuff that Nagato is doing. It seems like she's just planting the idea in Senpai's head, like, hey, I like you, over and over and over again. Hey, I want to be with you, over and over and over again. That Senpai is starting to think, oh, I want to be with her. Oh, I wouldn't mind being with her. And the good thing about this is Nagato is so fun to be with. Like, he enjoys her company. He wants to be around her. When she's not around, he misses her. And she's been putting herself out there so much that he's expecting her. He's expecting to hear a call from her. He's expecting for her to show up. And when she's not doing anything, he's like, oh, where is she? And that just encourages him or gives him the motivation to reach out to her. So kudos to you, Nagato, for doing that. Like, I don't know if you're planning that, but you're doing so good. You're doing so good at letting him know you like him. Especially, oh my gosh. Okay, so this is like one of my favorite scenes. One of my favorite scenes is it was like a hot day and they're walking home and Senpai's like drinking from a bottle, right? And then Nagato is like, hey, she takes a bottle, she drinks from it, she gives it back. And normally when we see this, it's like, ooh, indirect kiss. Ooh. But Senpai's not thinking about it at all. He's not. And then for the first time, they're exchanging numbers, contact. And then she says, well, if you ever think of anything pervy, I can sense it. And I'll send you this sticker, and it's a sticker of like a cat that says perv. And he's like, no, you wouldn't. No way. I don't think about anything pervy. She's like, you never know. And then they part ways. And as he's walking, he takes a sip from the bottle. Or he's about to take a sip from the bottle. And he's like, wait, Nagato drank from this. And this is where we get the indirect kiss thing. He's like, oh, indirect kiss. And he's thinking about her lips. And he's like, it's not a real kiss. It's not a real kiss. And like, he's like, totally psyching himself out. And all of a sudden, he hears like a ringtone from his phone and he looks at it and it's the perv sticker. And it's like, oh my gosh, she totally knew he was gonna think that stuff. And she was right there. She saw him look at the bottle, hesitate to drink from it, and contemplate everything before he starts drinking it. She knew this was gonna happen. She is planting the seed, planting it, making him think stuff. Oh, I love it. I really like this. So Nagatoro has this mischievous side of her, and by episode 7 at the festival, this is where Senpai catches on her teasing. Like, he notices that she gets shy and stuff. Like, especially in those scenes where, like, she gets those sweat drops, where she gets those, like, squiggly eye things, where she's, like, calling him out on doing something, but she's not really expecting him to actually do it. And when he's about to take action, she gets really nervous. So he's picking up on this stuff, and he's starting to counterattack. He's starting to call her out on things. And this is really putting her on the spot. Like, for example, when at the festival, they go to see the fireworks. Senpai takes her to like a really good spot. It's dark. Nagatoro is teasing him. He's like, oh, you dragged me to like a dark place. You want to do stuff with me? And then that's when Senpai's like, what kind of stuff? She's like, you know, stuff. Sleazy stuff. He's like, what do you mean by sleazy stuff? She's like, you know, sleazy stuff. And he's like, details. He's calling her out, and she's like getting nervous. She's getting shy. Her blushing. She's blushing more. And it's like, oh my gosh, you really do like him. You really want to do stuff with him, and you're really shy. You're really, oh, it's so cute. Oh my gosh. This Nagatoro, she's like, she has so many facets of her, and you see that she's up front, but she's actually kind of shy. Like, oh, she has like, I don't know how to call it. Like, she has a rambunctious outer side, but she has like a soft, sweet inside. As I'm making this video, I am on episode 11, where the president of the art club shows up, and she's telling Senpai that they have to compete on their artwork and such. And Nagato is helping Senpai, and the competition is a little bit harder than she thought it would be, because the president of the club likes to do self-portraits, and the president has curves. She has really good measurements, and Nagatoro, she's a little girl. And so there's like some insecurities going on. So the president is good at art, she's passionate about it, and she has really good measurements, and she's attractive. And Nagatoro really wants to help Senpai, but Senpai is like, oh, I don't want you to be put in this situation. What if I lose? And then I do these portraits on you, I draw you, they are put in the exhibit, and everybody laughs at you, especially after I lose. And she gets really sad that Senpai starts to push her away. She's really sad about that. And she gets mad at him. She gets petty. And then finally, when Senpai realizes how much he cares for her, he puts himself out there and he asks her to be his model. He wants to draw her, and he tells her that he finds her attractive, and she's like, ooh! Like, she's happy about it, but she's also a little embarrassed about it. And he's calling her cute, and then they're both embarrassed about it. Like, it gets like a little awkward, and she makes light of it again. She's like, what'd you say? What did you say? And he's like, no, I said you're... And this is where Nagatoro does very well at not blowing off the topic like we see in some animes where it gets like a little awkward. Like, you know how those... I get annoyed with some shoujo romance stories where the relationship is progressing and then they blow it off and say, oh, it's just a joke. Not in this rom-com. This one, they're like, it happened. We're addressing it. And we're never forgetting it. And that's my take on the character Nagatoro from the anime Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro. What do you guys think? Do you guys have other thoughts about her? what else do you want to share about her? Let me know in the comments below, and let me know what you think about this video. If you want to talk outside of YouTube, there's a Discord. Discord link is available in the description. I also stream on twitch.tv/LaHiloSuperFina. People who watch these videos do like to stop by the streams, have that one-on-one real-time conversation. You guys are more than welcome. Outside of YouTube and Twitch, I host podcasts across worlds where we talk about anime, manga, and other things we're interested in. If you like podcasts like that, link to the podcast is in the description. We are available on all platforms. Other than that, my name is Leihua, and this is the Superfina channel, reviewing Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagatoro, talking about the character Nagatoro. Hope you guys like this video, and I will see you on the next one. Laters!
Huge thanks to my Patreons and channel members for making this video possible. If you also want to be part of the Superfina party, you can click over here or become a channel member. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next video. And I do stream live on Twitch every Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. Hope to see you guys there, and I will see you on the next video. Fist bump.